look, that's right.
They're the backbone of the supply chain, but their industry, crushed by a wave of Omicron cases, is slowly grinding to a halt.
Something's got to give before the public realises, you know, what sort of pressure you're under.
We're losing people to the virus or, you know, close contacts in our warehouses, in our transport yards and at the retail store.
With supermarket shelves stripped bare, isolation rules for food and grocery staff were slashed last week. Today,
the most immediate extension of that is to all transport, freight and logistics employees, and that also will include those who work at service stations.
Those in healthcare, emergency services, energy and waste management also to be included, along with childcare and education.
We've been crying out to the government to come up with a solution for the crisis with staffing.
But some industries have missed out.
Well, we would hope that National Cabinet will go further than what we're seeing at this point. There are many sectors, so whether it be in retail, whether it be in hospitality, restaurants and catering, small business is being affected right across the board.
The sticking point continues to be access and availability to rapid antigen tests.
They are just as critical a public health measure as PCR tests were in the past or as vaccines are, and it is beyond belief that they are not provided to Australians free of charge.
The government says 10 million tests are on order and will arrive in the coming weeks. Urgent tenders worth just under $62 million for many more has also been placed.
What we need to do is focus our rapid antigen tests on the sectors that need them most. We're doing it for aged care.
This government can't continue to wait until a problem becomes a crisis before it acts.
The government thinking outside the box to get people back into the workforce. The unemployed, retirees and international students could all be called upon.
To look to people on Social Security, many of whom are really struggling right now with their own health, many of whom are actually needing more support.
Another proposal being floated is for asylum seekers who fled Kabul for Australia to be able to work.
Well, we need people. If they've previously driven for us, they're good enough to drive for the Australian military in Afghanistan. We need them. They want to work. It's a simple, it's a no-brainer.
Shubha Krishnan, SBS World News.